Roberts, acknowledgement on historical problem, especially deforestation and forest degradation, including forest fire in some countries, and highlight on progress achieved in the region in resolving the problem, the challenges faced, and commitment to transform to a long-term low-carbon and climate resilience development path. With environment and economic growth and ensuring the benefits for communities. Second is the commitment to work together between government, with civil society, research organization, and private sector to strengthen collaboration across the region, to share lessons and build on successful approaches that achieve economic development in the context of sustainable development. The third is the importance of education, awareness, raising, capacity building, demonstration activities, and collaboration with the private sector in generating good outcomes. In short, integrating climate and development agenda. The fourth is expectation and commitment for continuing collaboration through a stronger relationship and exploring opportunities for greater connectivity between parties, all the members of Asia-Pacific Rainforest Partnership to share experience using online platforms. The next is specific key messages from a high-level panel on forests in NDC and high-level panel on operationalizing Red Plus in the Asia-Pacific region. There's more specific about the importance of forests. In a broader context is land sector. In achieving NDC, in terms of mitigation, the unique role of forest is because forest can be a source of emission, but can also be sink. So forest can create problem, but forest can also solve the problem. This is the uniqueness of forest. And then Red Plus. Red Plus by concept is mitigation in forestry. And then in terms of adaptation, it's related to role of forest in food security, people livelihood, and climate resilience. And we heard yesterday the progress in Red Plus. In Red Plus countries, we have two cases, Indonesia and PNG, and also the challenges we are facing. So, thinking from the two high-level panels yesterday, the key issues and or challenges, first is about the cost effectiveness of forest activities. And then the issue of revenue mechanism, both for short and long term, to value forest in NDC. Issue on land tenure, especially land conflict, and for some countries, including Indonesia, is about fire incidents. And also climate finance is another issue. In terms of climate finance itself, it was identified that there is a need for scheme for today, tomorrow, and in the future. And then the need for collaboration between government and stakeholders, also private sectors, considering the rapid development of finance of climate finance. There are many different schemes of climate finance. And it should be supported by strong accounting, baseline, and inventory. And we could take up the lesson learned from Red Plus. The third is about access. Still finance, but this is about access. Access to finance and attract investment. Access, we have a case yesterday, access to GCF, to GCF, and then also bilateral. And how we could attract a private investment. The challenges are there because we know the nature of private investment, a requirement for host country, and for forest, this is another challenge. The shift of focus of finance from forest to agriculture approach, a landscape. For technical people or for forestry like us, like many of us, the landscape is a landscape-based approach is very logical. But this is not always the case when we talk about political side and also the implication of the implementation of the approach. And then also the shift of the fund to focus on action that address supply chain. The last is about the MRV. It was mentioned both in NDC, also in Red Plus. This include institutional arrangement and regulation, human resource capacity, and methodology, especially for addressing uncertainty. Colleague, ladies and gentlemen, it was the report from yesterday. All the PIC and their team have the complete note for our complete report from this summit. The day two, as we have eight sub-team from peatland, production forest, finance, investment and trade, ecotourism and biodiversity conservation, and community forests. Our recommendation is that each sub-team should take up issues addressed in day one sessions. As yesterday, we didn't have sufficient time to address those issues. And the second day session has sufficient time. Each session is allocated for 3 hours. From day one, we have summary from all session. Also, we have co-chair summary from the ministerial round table. We will just check when they are ready to when it's ready to be released sometime today. For the day two session, we recommend all PIC and team to deliver the key messages from their session. This is from a moderator who will take up as part of the summary for all session from day one, the whole event, the whole summit agenda in the closing session. And then for all PIC and team, should also later on prepare full report that will be coordinated by DGCC and FORDIA. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the wrap-up and also the arrangement for day two. And wish you a very productive discussion today, and with expectation we could answer all issues to be addressed and achieve what we would like to achieve from this summit, as reflected in the theme, protecting forests and people, supporting economic growth. With that, we close the first session in plenary, and I think the organizing committee will have announcement. Thank you very much. Good morning. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.